Hi yogis, Carlene here. Welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel. Today we're going to have some fun with tree pose, some different ways to balance on it, and if you have any issues, just think to yourself, I am Groot, and you will totally make it through. So to start, we're going to come into a temple pose, just doing a little warm-up of going from side to side, bending into one leg. It's kind of a ballet-inspired movement here, just getting legs warmed up, and then we'll start by warming up the arms too. So take your right arm, and as you move to the left, we're going to move it across and over your head. So across the body, over your head, across the body, over again. I think you get the gist. Warming up the shoulders. Last time here, hold it for 1 second. A little bit more than a second. Stretching out the side body and back to temple. Now we're going to come into our first tree. So coming over to one side, really ground into the earth with your left leg. Really grounding in with your toes. You don't necessarily, well, don't really grip with your toes, but grounding in with your foot. And we'll just start with a low tree for everybody. So balancing on the left leg, right foot comes to the inner ankle. And just holding the tree here for a moment. Feeling the nice balance. And stepping out of it, stepping back into your temple. Going back to our ballet-inspired movement here. This time taking our left arm as we go right, reaching left arm across the body and up. So the arm is moving as we are lunging to the right. Couple more here. Making sure you are breathing while we're doing this. It's a little bit of cardio. And last time, stretching over to the right, getting the left side body. And coming up into temple. I kind of am sliding to one side or the other. It doesn't really matter how you want to come into your tree, but grounding into the earth with the right foot and lifting the left foot to the inner ankle, hands come to heart center in your Anjali Mudra. And just balancing here, thinking about growing roots to the earth and stepping out of it back into temple. So we're going to do that again. Keeping our heart rate up just a little, and taking the right arm up and across. So really challenging our balancing since we're getting our heart rate going as well. And last one, hold it again. Coming back up and grounding into the right foot. Now you can stay at your low tree, if you want, at the ankle. Or if you want to come a little higher, moving already, come to the calf, kind of just growing the tree. You know, like baby Groot, now we have teenage Groot, and we start with adult Groot though, so. We're just kind of growing our tree. And from here, we're still going to hold it a little. Just inhale, reach the arms up. And exhale, back to heart center, namaste. A little challenge of movement there. Stepping back out into your temple. Back to our, well, temple lunges here. And left arm comes across and up. Making sure to breathe, of course, and if you have to breathe through your mouth, not a problem. And last one, hold it. Little stretch. Coming back up again, coming into the left. Now, grounding into the earth with your left foot. Bring our right foot, you can stay in the lower tree. Bring it up to maybe medium or teenage tree. pressing into the earth with your grounding foot. Making sure you are using that earth reaction force or ground reaction force to lift in and up all the way up that leg to hold your balance. So the balance is coming from the earth, not just holding it in your core. It's your whole body working. And that fun challenge, inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands back to heart center, namaste. And reach out into your temple. This time we'll mix up our temple a little bit. We'll do a little temple dancer pose and then we'll get into dancing tree. So from here we're going to take eagle arm. So right arm crosses under the left. If you need to hold it here, that's totally fine. If that's too much for you, you can do this too. But if you can wrap it all the way around, this is kind of where you're working towards, I guess. From here, just going to inhale and exhale. Dance and wave a little bit down. Inhale up. Exhale. So still moving back and forth in those legs, taking a little dancer moment here. Inhale up. Exhale, last time. So still getting into those legs, but not quite as cardio intensive. Inhale, reach up here. Exhale, coming back. Now for our challenging tree here, ground into the earth, really lift in and up all the way. You can place your foot wherever it needs to be. You can even bring it all the way up to your inner thigh. Remembering that it's okay if you lose your balance here. Happens to all of us. So yoga is about coming back into it and how you come back into it and kind of how you fall out of it. Not just collapsing onto the ground and being upset about it, but coming back in it like, oh, whatever happened and I'm back up. Now for extra fun challenge, so extend your branches to the sky. We're a full grown tree now and see if you can just release that left foot and do a little freestyle dance movement. Trees getting blown around by the wind, just like life, trying to knock you down, so have a little fun with it. A little movement, see where you can go. I want you to challenge yourself and try to make yourself fall. See how well you can stay grounded. And then hold it for a second wherever you are. Coming back down into a forward fold real quick. From here, bending the left knee, straightening the right knee a little bit straighter. Plant your left hand under your shoulder. Inhale, unfurl the right arm to the sky. Opening up the leg we just balanced on a lot. You can even rotate your palm to the back and then do an arm bind if that feels good to you. Exhale, coming back into your forward fold, rolling all the way back up to stand. And making your way back into temple for one last temple dancer. So again, we're doing eagle arm. So this time left arm comes under right arm. And inhale up. Exhale, just a little dancey wave. Down to center, inhale up. Exhale. And last time, inhale up. Exhale, wave, a little dance. Inhale up this time, last tree here. Really grounding into the earth with the left foot again, placing your right foot wherever it needs to be, ankle, calf, all the way up to the inner thigh if you are up for that challenge. And you guys know what's coming here, so brace yourself for the wind and the hurricane's gonna attack, and that's just how it is. So really feeling the length, the wave up through your spine, all the way up the crown of your head. Take that balance through the whole body again. Extend the arms. Full grown tree here. And then gently release that right foot. And a little dancing freestyle moment on this side. Really holding, well, trying to hold your balance, but also trying to challenge yourself and make yourself fall over. See what kind of crazy things you can come up with. It's your yoga practice. Don't worry about looking silly. Everyone's silly. It doesn't matter. And woo! See, I'm losing it too. That's kind of the goal. And again, pause for just one quick second. And forward fold on that side. Really long spine here. Bend the right knee this time. Straighten the left leg just a little more. And left arm unfurls to the sky. Right hand is planted underneath the right shoulder. And again, if it feels good to you, rotate that arm that's extended towards the sky. You can do an arm bind, bring it behind the back. And we rotate it first so that we're creating good shoulder health. And back to your forward fold. You can pedal up the feet a little bit more. And slowly make your way down to sit. Which I'm sure feels good after all of that dancing. We're going to do just a couple of cat-cows in a seated position. Feet are planted on the floor. And from here, rolling yourself down. You can take any yogi's choice stretches that you need, that you want. Sometimes it's nice, after doing some leg work, to actually lay against a wall and put your feet up against the wall. Help with some circulation, getting your lymphatic system flowing. I'm a little far away from the wall right now, but that would feel good, so I definitely recommend it. If you are near a wall, hit pause real quick. Get by one. And just stay in your Shavasana. You know, if you've got 3 minutes, 5 minutes, just really let the body cool down and reset. I had fun practicing with you today. I hope you had fun practicing with me. Be sure to subscribe if you did enjoy the practice. That way you get updates for when all the new videos come out. Definitely look forward to having you be part of the Nerdy Yogi community. And I hope to see you again on the mat soon. Namaste.